Our product is absolutely world leading. There's nothing else like it. It's completely disruptive on so many fronts.
Graphene Manufacturing Group CEO Craig Nicol is in studio with me now to discuss the results of the company's multi-year performance testing of G Lubricant, as well as the company's recent $5 million capital raise. Craig, it's good to see you.
Thanks for having me on again, Jonathan.
It's a pleasure. Now let's talk about these results. They enhance the performance and fuel efficiency of diesel and gasoline engines, particularly under high-low conditions. Can you talk us through those results and what they mean for the company?
Yeah, so basically, here's a G lubricant pack here. It's a bit dirty. I've just been putting it into my own car. So it's an additive that you add into engine oil. Typically, it's best to put into a new oil at about a 1% ratio of that fluid into an oil. So that 500 milliliter or half a liter pack goes into a 50 liter engine oil capacity. So it goes a long way. A small bit goes a long way, and then that basically increases the ability of lubricating around the piston. So there's about 30% of your fuel is wasted on the friction of the piston, and the engine oil really doesn't do a good job there. It generally has a trouble. It's where the biggest problem is of lubricating engines. And our product, which is a graphene fluid that we make here in Brisbane, enables that to be lubricated better and reduces friction, and therefore there's less push from the fuel pushing friction through, and it then increases fuel efficiency. So we've been testing this. We've been making this for about 8 years, but we've been testing it for about 4 years all over the world in various different ways. And we've just summarized about 2 years' worth of engine testing with University of Queensland, and it very clearly shows an 8.5% or so in fuel saving, which is a really big fuel saving. And that's at the high load. Our product really likes the high load. The 80% to 100% load. So that's when the engine's really working hard. So where you typically take off from lights or at really high speeds where you're going into the wind for air resistance, that's where you see the high loads. And we perform best then. Now we've seen more than 8.5% increase in fuel efficiency in customer testing over the years. So we're pretty confident that, the 8.5%, and that's basically, that's all been reviewed by University of Queensland as well. So it's quite clear, very high performing additive, very easy to use. Our graphene in the end only in the end takes 1 in 10,000 mix ratio in the final oil. So the amount of graphene you put in the final oil is 0.01%, but you're getting the 8.5% or so increase in efficiency. So it really does mean it's a low risk outcome for engines. Right now, we're just saying, to really use it in no or kind of past warranty engines. As we go through, the different approval processes, we feel pretty confident that we can get through those, and then maybe you can use it easier in your engine with warranties. But after years of testing, as I said, I put it in my own cars. We think this is right to test, right to go out, and that's what we announced, and that's why you can now buy it online.
So pretty extensive testing there, and as you mentioned, commercial rollout is ready to go. What does that look like, and what markets are you targeting?
Yeah, so being from Shell for 20 years, I was a fuels and lubricants engineer. Then I was marketing manager for industrial sector for Shell Oceania when I was 26, and so over years of knowledge around energy fuels, I've come to know that the diesel engine market is really a business. Fuel market. There's about $1.7 trillion worth of fuel into diesel, including taxes and duties around the world sold. So there's 34 of those markets, countries that are above $10 billion sales. And those are the countries that we're going to target. We're launching in Australia for the B2B truck market. That's already lined up with very clear advertising. It's very easy to buy online, very easy to ship. And that it's good margin product for us. And it's very good savings for the truck owner. And 95% of the market in Australia and around the world, very similar numbers, are owned by owner drivers. And they don't really have the ability to reduce fuel pricing with negotiations with big fuel companies. And they're actually moving most of the goods for Australia, and they're finding it pretty tough right now. So we think this product should save them somewhere around $8,000 a year of fuel at that high load a year, and be quite cost, you know, neutral really in the total scheme of things. Mm-hmm. And it's really a simple matter of pouring this into their engine, and then they'll be able to see the response immediately. So it's a good product for, you know, hardworking area of really doing it tough on costs, and diesel pricing is certainly not going to be reducing anytime soon. And we've got lots of engineering data to say why it does what it does. There's an enormous amount of science behind this. We're just world leaders at it, but we're, you know, not the only ones who thought this could happen. That can be easily found up on AI if you want to search it, what graphene does in engines. We're just absolutely world leading in our ability to make it and then put it into an oil and prove that it works.
Yeah, certainly in this cost of living situation that we're in, that $8,000 saving, it's pretty substantial. I want to touch on your partnership with Battery Innovation Center of Indiana as well. Can you talk me through how that came about and how that feeds into the development of graphene aluminium ion batteries?
Yeah, so we've been developing a graphene aluminium ion battery here in Brisbane with University of Queensland and working for Rio Tinto. They're paying us roughly $3 million a year to develop that battery for their large trucks on their mine sites. And we're now progressing through what's called BTRL technology readiness level 4. And in that, we need to optimize and go towards scaling. And in that phase, we sought to see how we could do that. We could have built a plant around $10 to $20 million, which we probably will still do eventually. But this initial phase, we're really looking to see how we can scale with minimal cost and get also full benefit of having somebody who's done it many years and also have the equipment that's very configurable. Because we use lithium ion equipment to make our batteries, but we only use aluminium ion salts, so and our carbon. So it's a very simple battery to make. In fact, it's simpler even than lithium ion batteries, but using all the same equipment. And of course, one of our directors is Bob Galyon, who's one of the preeminent battery innovators and leaders of the industry, technically wise. For many years, he was the second employee at CATL, the largest battery company, and built most of their equipment, built most of their factories. And he lives in Indiana, and he's very close to the Battery Innovation Center. I've been there personally. They're great guys. They've done over 500 battery development projects. Our product is absolutely world-leading. There's nothing else like it. It's completely disruptive on so many fronts. And they're really keen to be involved. You know, there's many American potential customers that could benefit from it. And also, we have our own battery development center, and that's not going away. So we have that here in Brisbane, and Waste Group will be able to send materials over there for them to develop and test the batteries. And then through their scale-up equipment, we can scale up then through a configured way. Rather than go and buying $10 to $20 million of equipment and working out, actually, for aluminium ion batteries, we need it slightly differently. So we can do all that optimization with them. Of course, they're very connected. They'll pretty much work for every battery manufacturer there is in the world and help their batteries. So it's a really big opportunity for us. And you know, for them, I think they're quite happy because we really are quite innovative, and they really like that as well.
And everything we've just discussed here now, it will be supported by a $5 million raise. Where will the funds go, and what's next for the company?
Yeah, so there's three main areas. It's a really exciting year for us. We've got we're coming into three of our products now are out for sale in your marketing and testing of a very large companies, and we still have, you know, that's still ongoing. That's growing in terms of companies that are testing the products and wanting to see how they can use it in their products, and they're all big global names. And we need to support that with new salespeople in growing the production as well. So we'll put in more production capacity as well in graphene and blending, and but also increasing the sales team. And we'll be having different platforms to be able to sell our product direct, but also we'll have large commercial deal conversations with our sales teams and large customers. So it's a multi-channel kind of approach, which you'd typically take for these kind of products. And we need to develop that over the next year. And, you know, that's well in train, but that money will definitely help there. The increase in production capacity will definitely enable us to bed down our next generation technology, which is really exciting. We'll be planning to radically increase our ability to produce graphene per hour with one unit. And so once we've done that, we'll be able to come out and say what we've done, but that's a relatively low amount to be able to do, you know, probably just a bit more than $1 million. And then that'll really increase our production capacity. And the third area is really looking at an uplisting to a major American exchange. So the preparatory work for that, you know, currently we're on the TSX, OTS, OTX, OTC, QX, sorry, and then we're on the Frankfurt Exchange. So we're really looking to complete the transition to an Australian-American company. And the, you know, we'll probably still be on the TSXV or the TSX, but the end game for us is an American in exchange, which really sees the benefit of deeper markets, obviously the biggest markets there are, and sees the benefit of our technology and what it can do. It's also the largest, you know, one of the largest natural gas producers in the world. And that enables us to see towards building plant there. Our customers are there, and we've already had very good reception from a number of key banking institutes and firms in New York who really want to see us, you know, go on to that kind of American of that area. So that's the third area, and, you know, that's really quite exciting. We should be able to really push through that this year.
Great. Lots to look forward to. Thanks for your time today.
Thank you, Jonathan.